In this session, we will have some output examples on Chapter 9.1, which is about exception handling. So we will have the following example. It says, assume you have two variables, x and y. So we have integer x equal 100, y equals 200. And then we will have a try block, catch a block, and we will have to find the output. So let's start with the following. We have x as 100 and we have y as 200. The first statement, it says, do the output x equal the value of x? So we will have the output x equal 100. Then we will start our try block. So these are the boundaries. This is the opening and this is the closing of the try block. So a try block should include this statement. The first statement, it says, do the output of y equal the value of y? Currently, the value of y is 200, so we will have y equal 200. And then we need an if statement, if x is greater than 0. In our case, x is 100, so 100 is greater than 0, so we will execute these two statements. X should equal 0. So we will need to change the value of x and x will be 0. And then we need to throw an exception and the message is too much. You will notice that we have many statements here within the try, but we should not execute any of them because we have an exception. So the exception will just exit the try block and it will go to the catch. Within the catch, we have one statement e.getMessage, which means output the message too much. So we will have a message that says too much. Once we are done with the catch block, we will have more two statements, the value of x and the value of y. So we have the value of x as 0, the value of y as 200. So in this example, we started with two variables and then we just compare the value of x. Because it's 0, then we have a new exception. And then we need to go to the exception and we need to ignore whatever there within the try. Once we finish with the catch, the last two statements we have are x equal y equal, and then we need to output the values of the current x and y. The other example we have to do it with arrays and a try and a block. So we will start with the statement integer bracket try equal new integer 4. So we will declare an array. The array will be of size 4 element and we will have the index 0, 1, 2 and 3. And then we have another variable x equal 5. So our array is called try and we have another variable x and the initial value we have it as 5. Then we have a loop. For integer I equals 0, I less than a try.length, I plus plus, try at index I equal I plus 1. So it says, if I is at location 0, the value inside this location, it should be I plus 1. So it should be 0 plus 1 and this will be as 1. And similarly, we will go with the other elements. So when we have the location of I as 1, then we will just do the following. Try at location I equal I plus 1. So try at location 1 equals 1 plus 1. So this is will be 2. And then when we have the value of 2, the location as in 2 will be 2 plus 1, which is a 3. When I is located at location 3, try at 3 equals a 3 plus 1, which is 4. So we will end up with initializing the elements in our array and they basically will be the value of the index plus 1. And then we have another for loop. The for loop, it says from 0 up to the end of the array, output the element at location I. So what we need to do, we need to output the element 1, 2, 3 and 4. And that's why you will see in the output, you will have 1, 2, 3 and 4. These are the four numbers in the output, and these are representing the elements in your array. Then we will start our try. So this is the beginning of the try and this is the end of the try, which means these are the statements within the try block. We need to execute all the statements. If we have no exception, we need to finish all the statements within a try. But if there is an exception, we need to exit the try block and we need to go to the exception. And this is the exception. This is the beginning. This is the end of the exception. We have only one statement. It says e.getMessage and we have to display the value of x. So starting with the try block, we have another for loop. It says start from 0 till the end of the array. The first thing we have to do is we have to output x. So we have the current value of x is 5. That's why we have here as 5. Now the second statement, it says if a try at location I equal x, the current value of I is 0. It means go and check the element at location I, is it having the same value as x? So we will go and check. This is the value 1. Is it the same value of x, which is 5? It's not. So we will not do the f. We will go to the else. Within the else, it says x minus minus. So the value of x will be changed and the value should be as 4. Once you are done with the else, you have another statement. Do the output of a try at location I. So this is a try. The location is still 0. The element at location 0 is 1. So we will output 1. So far we did one iteration of the for loop. Now we have to go back and do the second iteration because these are the boundaries of the for loop. So once you finish one iteration, you have to go back and you have to increment I. Now I will be incremented and I will be pointing to location 1 and then we'll start from the beginning. Do the output of x. So the current value of x is 4 because we have decremented in the previous iteration. Go and check the element at location I, is it having the same value as x? The element at location I is currently 1. The element at location I is 2. Is it having the same value as x, which is 4? It's not. So we will go to the else and we decrement x. So we will go there and the value of x will be as 3. And then I will need to go and output the element at location I. So the element at location I will be as 2. Still, we are doing very well with the try. We have no exception. And still, we are within the for loop. So we need to go back to the next I and we need to go with the execution. So once we move with the I now, I will be moving to location 2. So again, we have to mention, go and have the following. System.out.println output the value of x. The current value we have it of x is a 3, so we have 3. Go and check the element at location I, is it having the same value as x? A current I is having value 2, the element as 2 is a 3. A 3, is it equal to x, which is a 3? Yes. So we need to execute the exception. Executing the exception, it says we have to go there to the catch and we will do the execution of the eGetMessage and display the value of x. So e.getMessage will display the message between the double quotation there. So we will have a message found. A plus, what is the current value of x? The current value of x is 3. And this is, will be the end of the output. If there was here more messages to be at the end of the catch to be displayed, then we need to display them. But for this current example, it's only up to the catch. So in this example, they started with an array, initializing the array, and then we went through the elements of the array. And if it is equal to a current value, which is x, then we need to go with the exception. So out of this chapter, the things that you need to be aware of is what is the meaning of a try and catch and how to find output. If you have small output questions, they have a try and catch. They could have simple variables or arrays. And remember, with arrays, you may have loops. So within the try, If you have an exception, then it means you have to ignore anything within the try. So here, for example, within this try block, we have a for loop. And although we didn't finish the for loop, just because we found an exception, it means we have to go to the catch and just ignore the remaining of the for and the remaining of the try block.